Hi there, I am Wally. You may be wondering what I'm doing here. Well, let me start again. I am Wally and I am autistic. For those of you who are not familiar with this term, autistic is a person who suffers from a neurobehavioral condition called autism. But what exactly is autism? Well, it can be a tricky question because autism can be a lot of things. This condition is now being referred to as autism spectrum dysfunction because of its variety and diversity of symptoms. Quite possibly, my autism may be different from another autistic, and that his or her autism may also be different from another autistic, and so on. However, there are three basic symptoms that are observed in all types of autism. Social interaction challenges. Deviant responsiveness and difficulty in communication. Cognitive dysfunction and insensitivity or oversensitivity to certain stimuli, including sight, hearing, smell, taste and touch. Tendency to engage in repetitive behaviour throughout life on a daily basis. It may involve pacing, head rocking and hand flipping, etc. Now, let me evaluate myself according to these symptoms. I've never felt comfortable in social circles. I don't go out with friends or in gatherings, even though I have nothing else to do, and usually I feel out of place and panic in social gatherings. So, first symptom, check. I have trouble assessing how my words or actions will affect the other person psychologically. I have a really bad reputation for being blunt, and quite frankly, I have no idea why my words can hurt people. Most people tell me that I don't respond when I'm spoken to. I know that they're talking to me, but I feel a lot of background noise, which makes it hard for me to focus on one point during conversations with multiple stimuli involved. Along with that, sometimes I cannot assess the hidden meanings in conversations. For example, if I'm asked to take my seat, I would pick up my seat and ask, "Where to?" So, second symptom, check. Since my childhood, I have a strong tendency for head rocking side to side. It calms me down. I have these episodes daily and quite often multiple times in the same day. So third symptom, big check. Enough about me. Let's go through some important facts about autism. Autism is known to affect 1 in every 60 individuals, with boys at 5 times more risk to be autistic than girls. Quick question. Do you think the dominance of autism in males has something to do with their gender, more specifically with the Y chromosome? What causes autism is still unknown. It is believed that a cocktail of genetic, environmental, and psychological factors contributes towards autism. Autism is broadly divided into 3 major types. Classical or Kanner's autism, often referred to as severe autism. This type usually covers the low-functioning autism. In this case, autistics have the same but more severe symptoms, along with certain other developmental disorders. A very low IQ, loss of cognition, speech, antisocial behaviours and mental retardation in extreme cases. Asperger's syndrome, also called as high-function autism, tends to have the basic symptoms but with low severity, so that the individuals suffering from it have a very good chance of a normal life. Asperger's syndrome has known to be associated with high levels of IQ, with individuals that may lag in certain daily races of life, but are super smart at stuff that appears to be very difficult for smart but non-autistic individuals. These excellency may include problems in science, art, math, and music, to name a few. Can you imagine someone who got the highest score in SATs twice, but can't ride a bicycle properly, and gets confused in easy tasks, like opening a push or pull door? The third type, also known as pervasive development disorder, or atypical autism, it usually involves more sociological and behavioral associated deviations, and is a rather less studied type of autism.